Hello friends, welcome to engineering tutorial. So this is the third question which we are going to discuss on the application of superposition theorem. We have already discussed two questions. So this is another circuit. Okay, it consists of two DC voltage sources, values 2.05 volt and 2.15 volt, and they have two resistors connected to them, 0.05 ohm and 0.04 ohm respectively, and we have another 1 ohm resistor at the bottom. We have to determine the current flowing through this 1 ohm resistor. The direction is mentioned here. We can call it from right to left. Okay, this is the reference direction. Now, as there are two voltage sources, it will take two steps. First, we have to consider the 2.05 volt. Short circuit the 2.15 volt, then we have to consider the 2.15 volt, short circuit the 2.04 volt, and we have to determine the current through the 1 ohm resistor on the two cases. Okay, so first let us consider the 2.05 volt, step 1. So we are considering the 2.05 volt, circuit will be this is short circuited, 2.15 volt. This is 1 ohm, this is 0.05 ohm, 2.05 volt, 0.04 ohm. This is 1 ohm. Now let us take the direction of the current as I dash. Okay. Same, right to left, matching the original reference direction. Now we know this is the only voltage source here. And if you look at this circuit, 1 ohm and 0.04 ohm, they're in parallel connection. The two ends connected at one point, the two ends connected at the same two points. So they are in parallel connection, 1 ohm and 0.04 ohm. Now I've posted around 6 videos on the equivalent resistance of circuits. We have discussed various types of complicated circuits. We discussed about equivalent calculation of resistance, inductance and capacitance. 555 videos I have posted on each topic, so you can check out in the circuit theory playlist. Okay, so 1 ohm and 0.04 ohm, they are in parallel connection. Let us first calculate the equivalent resistance, 0.04 ohm. So it will be 1 into 0.04 by 1.04. So that will be 0 point, let us calculate it. So it will be 1 into 0.104, it is coming around 0.038 ohm. Now so we can redraw the circuit as this. Two point zero five volt, 0.05 ohm, 0.038 ohm. Now let us say this current is I subscript O. It will always start from the positive terminal and at the negative terminal. It always happens like that. Now this I naught, it will be 2.05 by the total resistance, that is 0.05 plus 0.038. So that will be, just calculate, 2.05 2.05, 1 by 0.05 plus 0.038. I am using a calculator. If it is allowed in the exam, it is always allowed, calculators are allowed, you can do that, or you can do it by yourself. But in most of the examinations, calculators are allowed, or they have their own virtual calculator system if it is a computer based test. So it is 23.2 ampere it is coming, 23.2 ampere. So this current, okay, we are talking about this current I naught, it is coming as 23. This is, these two are same. I naught is coming as 23.2 ampere. Okay, let me erase this portion. So we calculated I naught as 23.2 ampere, and we all calculated this equivalent resistance, the parallel, to calculate this value. So now we have to determine this current I dash. So this is 1 ohm, this is 23.2 ampere, this is I dash. So again we have to apply current division rule here to get the value of this I dash. This is a two resistor form, so I dash will be 23.2. we have to determine it through this 1 ohm resistor, so we'll multiply the other resistor, which is 0.04 divided by the sum, 1.04. I have already posted videos related to current division rule, voltage division rule. Okay, you can check them out in the circuit theory playlist. So the value is coming as 0.89 ampere. This is I dash, 0.89 ampere. And it is also from right to left. Okay, I dash. So this is because of 2.05 volt considered alone. Now in the step 2, we'll consider 2.15 volt short circuited 2.05 volt. This is step 1. So the output, the current, the contribution because of 2.05 volt is 0.89 ampere. Direction is same as the reference direction. Okay, so now let us do step 2, considering 2.15 volt short circuiting the 2.05 volt. So in step 2 we have to consider the 2.15 volt and short circuit the 2.05 volt. So let us redraw the circuit. This is short circuited, this is 4 ohm, this is 1 ohm. Okay, so now here if you look at resistors 1 ohm and 0.05 ohm, they are in parallel. Okay, 1 ohm and 0.05 ohm are in parallel. So let us calculate the equivalent resistance, 1 into 0.05 by 1.05, which is coming as, let us calculate. So now we'll calculate the equivalent resistance between 1 ohm and 0.05 ohm, which are in parallel. So the result will be 0.05 0480. Okay, so if we redraw the circuit, it will come as like this. This is 0.04. This is 2.15 volt. Okay. Now, this current here, let us call it again as I subscript O. We have to determine this current, which is same as this. The same thing. They are the same thing. Here we have just combined the equivalent resistance of 1 ohm and 0.5 ohm, which is 0.048 ohm. So these, the same thing here, this I0 and I0. So that will be 2.15 volt divided by the total resistance, which is 0.04 plus 0.048 ohm, which is 0.088 ohm. So this value is coming as 24.43 ampere, or let us call it as 24.4 ampere. Okay, so this is 24.4 ampere. Now we have to determine this current I double dash. Let us call it as I double dash. The direction is same as the original reference direction. So let us remove them, these two things. So if we look at this circuit, one ohm, 0.05 ohm, and this is I naught equals to 24.4 ampere. So again, this is a two resistor form, and we have to apply current division rule to find out this current I double dash. So current division rule, if we apply here, it will be I double dash equal to 24.4 into the other resistor, which is 0.05, by the sum of the resistor 1 plus 0.05, which is equal to, the result will be 1.16 ampere. And here also the direction of the current is from right to left, same as the direction of this. Okay, so we have determined the currents because of 2.05 volt and 2.15 volt, I dash and I double dash. Now I dash, the value of I dash which we calculated, it was 0.89 ampere from right to left. I double dash is coming 1.16 ampere. This is also right to left. The original current which we want, that is also in right to left. Right to left, going from right to left. So it will simply be the sum. I is equal to I dash plus I double dash, which is 0.89 plus 1.16 ampere, which is equal to, will come around 2.05, I think. Let us calculate. 9 plus 1.16, 2.05 ampere. Yes, 2.05 ampere. So this value Okay, this current I flowing through the 1 ohm resistor is equal to 2.05 ampere. So superposition theorem is basically this. We have to consider each source, whatever it is. It is a voltage source or a current source alone. At a time, you have to consider only one source, be it a voltage source or a current source. And you have to deactivate the other sources. How to deactivate? You replace the voltage sources by short circuit, current sources by open circuit, and find the response, be it current flowing through a circuit element or voltage drop across the element. In this case, it was current flowing through the 1 ohm resistor. You have to analyze the value of each response because of a single source, and then at last you just add them up together, which we did here. And another important thing is to take care about the polarity of the voltage or the direction of the current which is being mentioned in the question. In the question, the direction of this current which is being asked is from right to left. So here, for simplicity, we took all the responses, that is I double dash or I dash, also in the same way, so that we just have to add them up together. If it would have been the opposite direction, here minus sign would have come. I've already told this in the previous questions. So this is the third question related to application of superposition theorem. So I hope you like this video, and please subscribe my channel Engineering Tutorial for more such videos related to electrical, electronics, instrumentation and communication engineering. Have a great day. Thank you very much.